In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use three different types of UV images to create these Christmas ornaments. Let's create a UV sphere. Right-click to shade smooth. Ctrl-1 to subdivide. Let's add a material, and take a look at its built-in UV map. Please remember to click this UV sync selection button. I'll open an example image file. Nothing will show up even after switching to object mode, and activating the render preview. That's because we have not added the image to as an image texture yet. Also, the background color is gone. I would highly recommend you to use an external application to edit the UV image after exporting the layout first, as it's much easier to edit the imported image that way. Let's export the UV layout. I'll use Photoshop to edit the image, but we can use other applications like Krita. Here it is. The idea is open the example image, copy, and paste it to the exported layout image like this. Select all. Ctrl-C to copy. Open the exported UV layout image. Ctrl-V to paste. If we move the image like this, the end result would look less stretched. Please remember to save after hiding the UV layer first. Let's see what will happen to the edited example image. That looks better than the previous one. Let me duplicate the image layer and move it upward like this, and save. Let's import the image that was just saved. In this first example, we were using a UV map that was already created by Blender. I'll show you how to project a UV from view. In edit mode, type 3 to face select. Type U and pick project from view. The image got cut off because we're now using a new spherical UV map. Scale the UV map with S to see what would happen. Even after we rotate the sphere, the image would get cut off because the example image was arranged according to the first UV shape. Let's export this new UV layout. This time, I'll use another example image. We can scale or move the example image by using the UV map's boundary as its limit. Let's see what would happen now. Do you see how there are two Santas? That's because the projection from view UV type stacks the UV map. Meaning there's Santa in front, and another Santa in the back. If we want to have the Santa image only in front, then we must select the back half from the side view, and detach it from the UV map. G to move, and S to scale. Check this out. The backyard Santa is now gone. Let's export this UV layout. It's time to create separate meshes. Let's delete this, and create a new UV sphere. Control 3 to subdivide. Right-click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. I'll add a shiny metallic material. Time to add a cylinder. Let's add some loop cuts with Ctrl, R, and subdivide it as well. Three inches to face select. Let's select the top face, and type, I, as in India to extrude inward. I'll use a torus to create a ring mesh. R, X, and 90, to rotate the mesh 90 degrees on the X axis. S to scale and G to move. Shift D to duplicate. Let's press the number button to make the materials unique. I'll apply unique colors. For the red one, let's use the built-in UV map. Connect its alpha to the BSDF node's alpha. Let's add the mix node, and another BSDF node for the background. Please adjust the roughness values for both images to see the example image more clearly. If both images have low roughness values, we can't really see the decal image at all. It's best to adjust one of them and have a higher roughness value. That's basically how we adjust two images to mix them together. For this example, let's project from view. That looks good. Let's work on the mix node. That looks good. I think the first ornament's decal image shouldn't be too reddish. For the third ornament, I'll use the half UV projection view method. Ctrl-I to invert the selection. Let's resize the snowflake image. Let's adjust the roughness. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.